Hi everyone, welcome to this video on working with form validation in a Syncfusion Blazor rich text editor component. In this video, I will show you how to set the validation rules, customize the validation messages, and set the maximum number of characters allowed in the RTE. I am using an existing Blazor WebAssembly app. This project is already configured with a rich text editor component within an edit form. Using a model, I have bound a value to the RTE using a property description. Implemented a button component to submit the form, and defined a method to show a message while submitting. Also, added a reset button to clear the RTE content and the form submitted message. To know how to configure the Syncfusion Blazor rich text editor component, please watch the video which I have shared in the YouTube card. Now run the project. You can see the rich text editor component with reset and submit buttons. Let me click on the submit button, it shows the message form submitted. You can notice that no validation is handled while submitting the form. Let me type something and click reset, it resets the RTE and the form message. Now, let me show you how to add validation rules to this RTE. The RTE supports validation rules such as required, min length, and max length. Let me demonstrate form validation using the data annotations validator. To achieve it, in the edit form, add the data annotations validator tag. This will add data annotations validation support to this edit context. Add the validation message tag and use the for property and specify the model's description field to display the validation message. In the form model class's description property, add the attribute required. This will specify that a value is required for this property while editing. Add the min length attribute and pass the value 20, so that the description property value length should be minimum of 20 characters length. In the same way, add the max length attribute and pass the value 100. In the SF rich text editor, enable the show char count property to show the number of characters in the RTE. Run the application. You can notice the character count is displayed in the RTE. Click the submit button without typing value in the RTE. It shows the error description field is required following the RTE. You can place the messages at your desired location. Let me type a few characters. You can see the character count in the RTE. Press the submit button, it shows the error message, minimum length 20 is needed. Let me add more text, you can see there are 110 characters. Since I have set the maximum length to 100, it shows the error message once the RTE editing is completed. Next, let me show you how to customize these validation error messages. To do so, in the required attribute, set the error message property with a custom message. Customize the min length attribute too. Also, do the same for max length. Run the application. Click the submit button without typing value in the RTE. It shows the custom error message. Please provide the description. Let me type a few characters and move out of the RTE scope. It shows the custom error message. It shows the custom error message. Please enter at least 20 characters. Let me add more text. You can see there are 110 characters. It shows the custom error message, please provide description within 100 characters. Now, let me show you how to set the maximum number of characters in the RTE. To do so, in the SF rich text editor, set the max length property with value 100. This will not allow more than 100 characters in the RTE. Let me check how this works. You can notice the character count and the maximum count displayed in the RTE. When I provide the value, you can notice the change in the count. Once it exceeds 85%, it changes the color to amber. Once it exceeds 90%, it changes the color to red, indicating it's nearing its maximum limit. Once it reaches, it won't allow entering any characters further. Thus, you can restrict the users to limit the characters in RTE. That's it. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key to use our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.